Yes, with this wonderful music, so will I say welcome to a new program of The Living Room. And my name is Tommy, I'm Josefsson, and together with me here in the sofa is Lars Adolfsson. And welcome, welcome. Wonderful to have you here.
Thank you very much. It's,
and we are happy to be here together again.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
The Living Room is always a great place to be.
Of course it is. And you know, every one of us, we are all time meeting in the living room, we are sitting and looking at the TV in the living room, and so on, and have a good time with our friends and so on. That's often happen in the living room.
Yes, the living room is beside the kitchen, of course, in a house, the heart, where people are coming together with different activities.
Yes, and you know, many TV channels, they have kitchen program, making the food.
Yes,
but we are in the living room. You know, we are finished with the food, and now we are ready for a spiritual food.
Yes, and we are sitting in the presence of God right here in the living room.
Yeah, and we are together with you right now in your living room.
Yes,
and we are
yes.
together. Your living room is joining our living room, and we have a good time together to seek the Lord to get the spiritual food. And you know, often we only sitting there in the front of the TV and do nothing, or we only sitting there enjoy some funny movie or whatever we are looking on. But you know, right now you have turned in on channel 316, and channel 316 not maybe have so many funny movies, but we have something that is a food for you, and that giving eternal life. And why, Lars, are these foods so important compared to the food we get in the kitchen and the food we maybe sometimes bring into the living room and sitting there and eating, compared to a spiritual food?
Well, the food we are eating is good for our physical body, and we need it, of
yes.
course. And but the spiritual food is the living food.
Yes.
It's bring life into our spirits. It's just number one, it's waking us up spiritually. Our spirit come to life. Without spiritual food, the Word of God, in some form of way, without that, the human spirit is sleeping.
Yes, that's
so
true.
So that's very important with to wake up with the Word of God. Sometimes it's can be some uncomfortable. It's not always so funny to be
waked up.
But
yeah.
It's surely necessary for every human being.
Yes, because early in the morning, when the watch is calling, wake you up in the morning, it's not all time you feel to stand up from the bed, and special when it's a little cold, and you know, you take your foot outside your blanket and you feel, ooh, it's cold, I will stay here. It feels so good to stay here. But you know that if things I need to do, I have an appointment and so on, so I need to stand up. So you only stand up and go. And you know, this is the time. This is the time you can feed your spiritual man. Feed and be strong in the Word of God. You know, it's so important to fill you up with the Word of God. And before that, we're starting this program today, we are talking, you and me, Lars, and my wife, Andrea, we was talking together that it's so important to read the Word of God, not only to read a part of it, but to read all the Word of God, from the beginning, from the book, the Genesis, to the Revelations. And all that between. We cannot only pick up some books and say, I only read the Psalms, I read the New Testament, or I read only the Gospel, because Jesus is the important things. I read only the Gospel. I not need the rest. I only need the Gospel. But you know, we really need all the text in the Bible. We really need to read from the beginning to the end. And Lars, you have really experienced this last 90 days. You have read the whole Bible on 90 days. That was a great experience.
Yes, absolutely. It's I have been reading the Bible several times before, about four times.
Yes.
And the New Testament I have been reading about six, eight times. But that has been in a long time, about a plan for a year or maybe 2 years, 1.5 years and so on. But this experience to really, in short time, read a lot.
Yes.
It's really happening, something is really happening, supernatural.
Yeah.
The spirit, the inner man gets life.
Yeah.
It's open up and something happens.
That's true.
First from the inside and then through the outside.
Yeah.
Meetings, people are just changing.
Yeah.
Because it's I'm changing first.
Yeah.
And there is a supernatural power in the Word of God.
That's true. That's true.
And the whole scripture is breathed out from the mouth of God.
Yes.
And as the same way Jesus breathed, blowed his breath out to his disciples, as the same way God has breathed in the scripture. So when we open the scripture and read, we can with faith to just take in that life, and
that's
something
true.
Is really happening.
Yeah,
it's really happening.
Something changed.
Yes, and just not only for me, but for whole my family, for my friends, for people I'm meeting. I can see things are just happening around me.
Yeah,
in a whole different way than it was before.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you know, the word of God is it's really strong here. It says in Hebrews chapter 4 and in verse 12. That's one of my favorite verses really in the Bible. But he's talking about the word of God. It says like this: for the word of God is living and active. You know, it's not only a dead letter.
No,
you know, you see,
it's
a white paper with a lot of letters on. No, it's not dead. It's living and active. You know, I like this word active.
Yes.
Because when you take the word into you, you really read it. And I have that same experience you have these 90 days. For a couple of years ago, I was very young that time, but I really read the Bible. I put aside like 8 hours every day to reading the Bible and pray. And people say, "Oh, you don't going to the work?" You know, in that period, I have lost my work, and I asking God, "What work shall I do? What shall I do?" And He says, "Pray and read my word." So I say, "Okay, that's my work. So I will read the Bible. I will pray every day 8 hours." And you know, for 4 months, I do that every day. And now, in that period of time, you're thinking, "Oh, how you living? How you survived?" You know, God provide. I was like a prophet, you know, the prophet Elijah. He hiding, and the bird coming with the food. And that was what the time that experience I have in this 4 months. That every day, exactly every day, in the mailbox, there was a envelope with the exact amount money I need for every day. It was really a special experience. And every Friday, there was extra in this envelope. So there was enough for Saturday and Sunday. And there was all time little extra. And when I put this little extra, there was little more. And what I need this Friday, there was exactly to pay 10% for all the money I have received the last week. It was really a special experience, because Paul, he writing, you know, that he if you don't have seed to sow, he will giving the seed to sow. And it was a very special experience. But for that four-month period, I have lost my work. I don't know really to do. I really give that time to God. And I really feel that my life was totally turned up and down, because the word of God make a change. It really make a change on the inside. And it's exactly what the word say here. Is living and active. And it's continue like this. Sharper than any double-edged sword. It penetrates even to dividing soul and spirit, joints and marrow. It judges the truth and attitudes of the heart. You know, the word of God, it's really judge your attitudes in the heart. Your attitudes to another people, attitudes maybe to another ministries, attitudes to your wife, your attitudes to your children, the change. And when your attitudes, maybe you don't self-observe that. You maybe not observe your bad attitude, but the word of God start to change your attitude in your heart. Maybe you don't really think about that, but the surrounding people around you observing it, and things start to change around you, and the attitude among people around you is start to change too. And that was little your experience too, Lars.
Yes, absolutely. And that's the truth. And you can put faith to the word
of
God.
True.
And when you do that, something explodes. That's the key to start a rocket.
That's really true.
That's very, very truth. And even if you don't believe and reading the Bible and praying, you can start in that direction too.
Yes.
Even if you don't believe it, something will happen anyway. So it's not depending on your beliefs, but when you put trust to it, it explodes in another way.
It's true. And so if you have been given a Bible, if you have a Bible standing in your amongst your book in your house, maybe exactly in your living room where you are sitting right now, you have a Bible there, and you have many time look on it. Maybe you have read some famous verses in this Bible, whoever, but you never really read the Bible. You know, it's time for you to take this Bible right now where you are sitting. Take your Bible in the front of you and start to read it. And maybe you don't really understand what you are reading. I remember a man, it's coming to us in the church, and he was young, and he ever exactly received Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. And now he coming to the church because he like to learn to know more about it and talk with people that knows him, that knows Jesus. So he come to the church and start to talk with us, and we asking him, yeah, so why you be a believer, and how you, who tell you about this? And he say, no one tell me about this, but I was studying philosophy, and I was very interesting about all these different great philosophers. And one of these philosophers have write that the philosophy of Jesus is one of the greatest philosophy in the world. So he's thinking, who is this Jesus and who is this very great philosopher? So I need to read his book. So he found a Bible. He had been given a Bible in the school, a New Testament. So he starts to reading there, and first the Gospels, and he don't understand any things. And he coming to the Gospel of John, and suddenly things start to coming in the right place for him. And he start to understand that he need to believe Jesus to understand. So he come to the point where he knelt down in the side of his sofa, close his eyes and close his hand and say, Jesus, I need to know you. I will give my life to you because you are the only way to the Father, and I need to know you. I need to learn to know you, and whatever I have do wrong in my life, take it away from my life. Let me start a new beginning with you, and let me to understand this book I reading. And he say, after that, he remember the priest, he all time say amen. So he end his prayer with amen. So, and after that, he open his Bible again and start to read. And suddenly, he understand what he was reading. And he was so happy. So he reading his New Testament 3 times, straight from the beginning to end. Of course, the revelation was a little hard, but he read the whole. And after that, he think, I need to go to a church. So he turned on his TV, and on the TV, there was a church there. So he think, okay, I go to that church because I have seen them on TV. So I can see some people there, so I can recognize them, so I don't feel outside when I come there. So he come to the church. And directly the host, there was a TV host in the program I have seen. The TV host was sitting there exactly inside the door when he come inside. And he says, oh, hi, I have seen you on TV. And so he have something to talk about, and the connection was there. But this man, he have Christian TV for many years, but he have never looking that channel. But he start to read the Bible, the Word of God, changed his life. And later on, this man was starting to work with Christian TV too, right? Exactly like we are doing right now, Lars. Yes. So it's wonderful. It's power in the Word of God. It's power, there is anointing, and the Word of God is living and active. It means that the Word of God make us to be changed, to be another one, to really judge our inner man, inner heart, you know. Because Jesus says, what the heart is filled up of, there was the mouth is speaking.
Yes, absolutely. So are you filled with the Word of God?
Yeah.
You will talk the Word of God in your own way, of course.
Yeah.
You don't talk
the language. You don't standing there and say, language, in sound, that and that, and no. This and this, and so on and so. No, you are speaking according to the Word
of
God.
Yes, yes, absolutely. And that is changing, because the Word of God is like the rain falling down on the earth. It doesn't go up again before it has done its work.
Yeah.
So
the rain is falling down, it's giving the growth.
Yes, the same thing with the Word of God. The Word of God also tells us that God is speaking to us.
Yes.
He's talking to us.
Wow.
We have a relationship with God.
That's true.
Not only through the Word, but it opens our minds, our heart, for the connection and the communication.
That's
with the living God.
Yes.
And some maybe say, but he doesn't talk to everyone. Yes, he is talking to everyone.
He talks to
everyone.
And
you can also read about that in several times and in many places in the scripture,
yes,
that he is talking to ordinary people. And when you know that, when you have read that, you begin to change in your mind.
Mm.
You are starting to, maybe I should talk to God. Let's see what's happening.
Yeah.
I have a little experience, but just before we started this program, I was drinking some water, and suddenly I had talked to God in the car on the way here about an idea I had to start a new part of my company, and suddenly Jesus just talked to me clearly when I was about to drink some water about how this should the name on it, the sign, and how it should be. He showed a picture clearly. Because why? Yes, because I had asked him.
Yes,
I had put my faith to, okay, let's see here if I should talk to him. What's going to happen?
Yeah.
I don't know what's going to happen, but I will try. So then the little faith about so small.
Yes.
Active a happening who can be how big you know, it's fantastic. And if every man and woman and child knew what they are having in the living room, it's a supernatural document.
That's true.
It generates a power about atom, atomic weapon, when you are starting to act on it.
Yes.
And when you are starting to pray according to it. If people just knew, everyone in the whole planet would read it all the time. I'm absolutely sure of that.
Yes, because the Word of God is changing us.
Yes.
From inside, you know, because to be changed as a person is not to be perfect on outside, have the perfect clothes, have the latest things on you. No, the thing is really changing us. We can change and fixing us outside. Some people, they operate their face and so on to be perfect. And you know, they are the perfect picture and maybe take off this with some operation. But you know, you don't need that. You know, start to change from inside. The Word of God is changing you and me from the inside completely. You know, it judges our attitudes. And when our attitudes get right with the Word of God, our attitudes gets right to different things in our life too. Maybe our attitude will be right to the food too. So we don't eat so much, so we have problem with the stomach. Or we doing the right thing. We speak on the right way to people. We eat the right things. And we will do the right things. It's like the prophet says in the Old Testament, I will write the word in the heart. You know, and God doing that. He gave us the Holy Spirit. He giving us the opportunity to live in a life in the supernatural together with him. And that is not any spooky things. That is a typical, naturally life to live. To live in a supernatural with God. Where it's natural to pray for the sick. Where it's natural to believe him for the miracle. To believe him to see change in people's lives. To believe him for life to be changed from the negative to the positive. Hallelujah. Because we can believe him. And we know that his grace is big enough and so on to if we're doing wrong, we can be raised up by him again. But you know, if we are changing our hearts according to his will, changing our heart according to his word, and that we obey his word, obey his direction in our life, we don't need to do the wrong things in our life. Praise God. Everyone is doing wrong, but we can coming and go stronger and stronger with him day by day and closer with him, and see our life be changing and going more and more according to his will. I read this morning from the Bible about Joshua. He follow Joshua. He follow Moses, and Joshua, he was the one is taking the people in to the promised land. But Joshua, when he was young and walked side by side with Moses, he was in everything staying. You know, when Moses put up a tent outside the camp where he's sitting and study the word, writing down what God telling him to do, speak to God face to face. When Moses left the tent, Joshua stayed there in the presence of God. And you know, you and me, we can choose to stay in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Yeah, but I have a work to look after. I have a family. I have that. I have a business. You know, we have so many things we need to do. But you know, if we put apart a time to stay in His presence, all the rest will be so easy. It will be easy to take care of your family. It will be easy to take care of your work. It will be easy to take care of your business. Like Lars here, he is thinking to doing a new things in his business. He have some idea and so on. He have some way he can do it. But is that only running away to all the different people you can talk with to get to run to the bank to borrow the money, run to a place where you can get workers and run to another place and so on? He was relaxing, sitting down, asking God, and God showed him the picture with the name, with the symbols, with how he should make it, and how he should... You know, it was mostly everything how you should arrange it in a second.
Yes, the plan came in a millisecond.
Yes,
and the fantastic with God is when He is coming with an answer or with a communication, it takes a millisecond.
Yes.
But when you are supposed to talk about it, it can take an hour. to grip the whole picture. But it comes like this.
Yes.
And you just know it. And the same thing when you ask God for wisdom, for a word of knowledge.
Yes.
It can come. An education,
yes,
that can take about, yes, half an hour to talk about, and that can be life changing. But when it comes to you, it can take a millisecond.
That's true.
So you even know the difference in time and space when you are talking to God. But it's fantastic, supernatural life.
Yes,
we are talking about here. And I must say that Jesus describes in John as the Word of God.
That's true.
So there's no different. The power, the same power that's in the Scripture, is the same power that lifted up Jesus and put him in the right side of the Father.
Yes.
And the same power that lives in us. So there is a real great power in the Word of God. And how do you do this? How do you come to grip this? Well, you can start. Well, many people saying that like this, but I don't believe this, so I cannot pray. I don't believe in prayers. Okay, let's stop there. If you just pray anyway, you just decide yourself, I will pray, even if I don't believe it. I will start to pray every morning, because I want to have this supernatural life. I want to have a relation with God. Even if I don't believe it, I will start to pray. And when you are starting to pray, you come to a contact with the living God. Something is changing inside you. It's a practice. You know, when you are going to skate or do anything that you haven't done before, it can feel difficult. It can feel that it's not you. It can feel dangerous. But when you are doing it for a time, you will experience that this is filled with joy. And you are getting better and better. And the better you are getting, the more fun and the more exciting it will be, and you come up to a new level, and the new level is new challenges. But when you can do the new challenges, you are getting filled with joy and happiness. And you are coming closer and closer to this life, this new life, that when you have accepted it and you accepted Jesus and put him into your heart, the new life starts there. And the eternal life, you have taken a step into the eternity. That's in that moment.
In that moment, yes.
And you the death has no power over you anymore. That's really strong and fantastic. And
that's really powerful if you are really thinking clear here.
Yes.
That from the moment you received Jesus,
yes,
as he is the Word, and the Word was flesh to him.
Yes.
And when we receive Jesus, because Jesus is the only way to the Father, at the same time we receive Jesus as our Savior and Lord, we are put into the eternal life. The yes. dead have no control over our life again.
No.
And that is really a secret, but it's so wonderful.
Yes.
And when we are walking with him, we can living more and more in this. And you know, when we are reading the Word, living in the Word, we are training to live the eternal life with God.
Yes.
That's true. You know, it's Henoch in the Old Testament, he walked with God, is written. And after 300 years, he walked so close to God, so he don't come back. And that's true. You walk so close to God that suddenly you cannot come back. You will stay with God. We should have one song here, Lars, with you, and we look forward to hear more music too here in the program today. You're looking at the living room here on channel 316, and today we are talking about this subject, you know, to put our faith in to the Word of God, because the Word of God is living and active and making changes in our life. It's there to change your life, to divide the spirit and the soul, to really judge the attitude of your heart. Hallelujah. It's so important. So please, Lars.
Thank you, Tommy. It's always the best to talk about Jesus.
Yes.
And to talk about the Word of God, it's a special feeling, and it grows all the time. And it's about walking by faith. You can't see everything before you are going. So when you have been taking one step, you will soon be glad to take the next step, and so on. But it's about walking by faith. Would I believe you when you say your hand will guide me every way? Will I receive the words you say every moment of every day. Well, I will walk by faith, even when I cannot see. Well, because this broken road prepares your will for me. Help me to win my endless fears. You've been so faithful for all my years. With one breath you make me new. Your grace covers all I do. Well, I will walk by faith, even when I cannot see. Well, because this broken road prepares your will for me. Well, I'm broken, but I still see your face. Well, you've spoken, pouring your words of grace. Well, I will walk by faith, even when I cannot see. Well, because this broken road prepares your will for me. Well, I will walk by faith, even when I cannot see. Well, because this broken road prepares your will for me. Hallelujah. Tack Jesus. Thank you Jesus. Some Swedish words came out there. But that's how it can be sometimes when you are in the presence of God. What your mouth talks, it's what the heart is full of. When you have begin to walk by faith, your heart will be filled by faith, and you will talk faith, and so on. And it's, this life will grow all the time, year after year, if you let it grow. If you don't stop, just walk. Walk by faith. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. That's wonderful, you know. Walk by faith. That's so important. Because walk by faith is to walk the right direction. Hallelujah. I will read here from John, the first chapter and verse 1. Because you are talking about it before you see the song. And it's written like this. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things was made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and the life was the light of man. And the light shines in the darkness, but the darkness had not understood it. Is another translation say and the darkness has not overcome. I like this word overcome. You know, the darkness could not prevail against the light, the power, the mighty power that Jesus comes with. The darkness maybe thinks they have overwin Jesus through the cross, but Jesus, there was the perfect plan of the Father, that Jesus who died for all of us, so every one of us could be coming into his grace, coming into his time of salvation for the human being. The darkness maybe for a moment was thinking, oh, we have win over the Son of God, but they could not overcome the Son of God. The Son of God, he make the complete and totally victory over the darkness. And that's why it's a living way for you and me to come in to Him and starting our eternal life here and now, right in the moment where we are right now. Praise God. Are they not wonderful, Lars?
Yes, absolutely. That's the most wonderful thing you can read about, and you can think about, and you can meditate on. Sometimes it's some words in the scripture that for the moment seem lightened up. It can talk to you. You can just feel that they are lifting up from the scripture.
Yes.
And that's I experienced that is an education from Jesus. Sometimes Jesus is God. First of all, Jesus is God coming to flesh.
Yes.
He is the Word of God, and He is the God.
Yeah.
He is God. And sometimes God is talking to us through the Word in the Scripture.
That's true.
And that's the same as Jesus talking to us personal.
Yeah.
And those words we can think about in the day, in the morning. You can come back to it and just memorize it, think about it, talk to Jesus personal about it. What do you mean here, Jesus?
Yes.
When you are talking to God, talk to Jesus, because when you are talking to Jesus, you are talking to the Father at the same time.
Yes.
And you are talking in the Holy Spirit, because without the Holy Spirit, you can't talk to Jesus. So
that's the way.
And
you know, that's very important. Like you are singing in the song here, walk by faith.
Yes.
You know, that's you know, this is a faith walk. We start to walk in faith.
Yes.
Because we cannot see everything at once. We don't see right here now. We're talking about to receive the eternal life to Jesus. Oh, I cannot see an eternal life. My skin get older, my hair get more and more white, and so on. And you know, in the beginning you can take the gray hair and take them out, but after a time this get more and more. You should not at last you will have no hair left if you take them away. So you only need to accept I get older. But you know, the life, the eternal life have start, and we walk by faith that we are on the way into the eternal life. And because you and me, our spirit, our soul is live forever. You know, okay, this flesh is get older and die and fall, you know, but it's like Paul, he says, you know, it's only for a temporary time. It's for this time, because we have a purpose, we have a work, we have a something God like us to do in this time. That's why we say our eternal life have start, and we walk by faith, not by sign. And you know, it's, you know, that is a Bible word. Is you found it in the second Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 7. That's not only something that we say, it's in the Word of God. That's very important, you know.
Yes.
You know, the whole song there that you're singing, Lars, was from this word.
Yes, absolutely.
Because we walk by faith. We walk by faith. We don't focus on the circumstances around us. You know, you maybe have heard this story about Peter, when they are out in the boat, he and the disciples, they was fighting with a hard wind and so on, and Jesus was not together with them, but because he have stay and pray to the Father, to have relationship with the Father alone. So in the middle of the night, he is coming there, walking on the sea. He walking on the water. And the disciples sitting there in the boat, they get afraid. They say, oh, help! What is coming going there? Oh, maybe a ghost. You know, they was really afraid.
Yes.
And Peter, he looking too. And Jesus says, not be afraid, it's me. And they recognize there was Jesus. And Peter directly, Jesus, if it's you, only say a word and I will come. And I will go there. And Jesus says, come. And Peter, the fisherman Peter, he had been so many times out in the water with his boat. He knows water. He knows the boat. He knows everything about fishing. But this fisherman, he walked on this word that Jesus says, come. He walked on it in faith. Not, he don't looking the circumstances. He don't looking on the water. He don't listen to his understanding that says, you cannot walk on the water. It is water, Peter. No, he don't listen to his understand. He walk by faith. He jump out of the boat. And he walk on the water by faith. He walk on the water. Because Jesus say what? He say the word, come. So he put his faith into that word, come. And because of that, he don't make anything to walk on this water. He only put his faith into this come. And he was going on the water. Then you and me put our faith in the word. He's showing us. Something happened. You and me can start to walk. Maybe not on the water, but walk through the circumstances is maybe try to rise up against us. Or if you are not so good to speak English, you're thinking, I cannot do this. I cannot do this because I'm not good to speak English. So I don't do that. But if God says, it's like I like the first time. I remember the first time I was on a mission trip where I couldn't speak in Swedish. God had been very nice to me many years. He let me go to countries where I couldn't preach in Swedish, so I was happy for that. But suddenly, he sent me to a country where if I have speak in Swedish, there have been like a tongues for all the people sitting there. They should have not understand any word I say. Okay, maybe when I say Jesus and God and so on, they couldn't pick it up. But the rest, they should not understand. Suddenly, I stand there with an English Bible and should preach in English. I was really nervous, to be honest with you. I was so nervous because I was not the best man in my classroom when I was in the school to speak English. There was much better than me, and I really tried to hide myself for the teacher because I was so afraid the teacher should ask me something because I know I could not answer. But God's grace was there. God says, go there and preach there. So I need to put my faith in that God have said I should go here and preach here. When I put the faith in that, I was speaking fluent English. Maybe a bit perfect, but fluent. You know, it's only it's the preaching only come out of me in English. And, you know, the people was happy. They liked what I have preached. But, you know, I was only surprised. And I'm thinking, wow, what's happened? I couldn't speak. And, you know, that's, you know, when we put our faith into what he says, he make, he take away the hindrance. And, you know, Peter, he walked there on the water. And in the middle between the boat and Jesus, his own knowledge take over. Peter, you know, you're a fisherman. You cannot walk on the water. No one can walk on the water. What are you doing? This is dangerous. Oh, you don't see, Peter. It's blowing. You will die, Peter. Your brain is speaking. Yes. But you know, and Peter start to listen to his brain, to his own knowledge, what's happened. He start to sink. And he shout out, Jesus, help me. And it's written there, at once, Jesus was there and helped him. And the wonderful thing is, Jesus don't carry Peter back to the boat. They walk together back to the boat.
Fantastic, really fantastic. And that's how can you take this into the life of yours today? Maybe you don't have to walk on water in the lake or in the sea, but you can have some failures when you have tried to do something, and you can have a bad experience when you are about to start some new project, or maybe some negative things have been happened back in your life. But when you can make a choice there, you can and those experience are making tracks in your mind.
Yes.
They're deeper and deeper and deeper, and the more you think about them, the deeper they are getting, those tracks. But Jesus have come with a new track.
Yes.
And you can think about him every day, in the morning, in the evening, and you can talk to him, think about him. And when you do that, when you are doing the same thing that failed about a year ago, when you're doing the thing today and think about Jesus, he will take you by the hand.
Yes.
And step by step you will succeed. And you are the only thing you have changed is your mind. Instead of thinking on the failure, you think about Jesus. And then the thing that happened to Peter will happen in your life too.
Yes.
And that's fantastic.
And like that, he walk on the water.
Yes.
You walking with your foot through this problem. You're walking over these tracks you have in your mind that says you cannot do it. You're a big failure. You see, before there was a mistake for you to do these things, and you say, but I feel in my heart, God put it in my heart to do these things. You know, this is, you are not a failure, but we need to put your focus on Jesus.
Yes.
And say, Jesus, give me the word. Jesus, give me the direction. Show me what I shall do and what I need to coming through this. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We shall take a short break here, and we are soon coming back here. And don't leave us. Stay, because this is your moment for a life-changing experience into the supernatural.
Welcome all Filipinos in this channel, 316 Victory Center here in Helsingborg, Sweden. If kung asa mong dapita, pwede mo matanaw anytime in the internet. So, tanaw mo opinion ng channel. Interesado, we pray for you. iampo mo na mo kung unsa inyong gustong ipampo. So mag-mail lang mo, magpadala mo sulat diri sa Sweden, Helsingborg, kay arong kung unsa inyong mga prayer requests. So among i-pray kung America, Filipino, Filipinas, Africa, Spain, Spanya, and all over the world. So welcome in this channel.
Welcome to channel 316. And we'd love to know where you're from. Those from Africa, you can email us on 316.tv and visit our page also on Facebook. Go in and like us and write to us.
So, you are so welcome back here in the living room together with me, Tommy M. Josefsson, and Lars Adolfsson. And we are sitting here and sharing with you today about the power in the Word of God. The power of the Word of God that is living and active, you know, dividing our soul and our spirit, and divide and really judge our attitudes in our heart. And you know, this is it's a very strong power in the Word of God. And why is the power of the Word of God so strong? You know, we're talking about that from the first chapter of John, that Jesus is the Word. And Jesus is the Word. It's coming in flesh. And the Word was with God from the beginning. And everything that we see around us, it's coming through the Word. And when we read in the in Genesis, as we say, it's written there, God says, let it be. You know, everything is created that we see around us is created through His Word. And the Word is Jesus, so everything is created through Jesus. Hallelujah, that is really amazing. The whole world, everything we can see around us is created through Him, by the Word of God. So everything we can see, and in Hebrew chapter 11 and verse 3 says like this, by faith, you know, by your faith we understand that the universe was formed on God's command, so what it seen was not made out what was visible. It's out of the visible. God make it through His Word. Praise God. Hallelujah. You know, us as a human being, we like to see everything. We like to take feeling on everything, you know. And some people, they say, oh, I go out in the forest and pray to the trees because I can see them. I can believe that. That's something good in that. And I feel good to walk there in the forest. Or like we read in the Bible about the children of God, they're making a symbol for a God to pray to. But you know, we don't need that because our God is high over everything. And we are not called to pray to the creation, but we are called to pray to the Creator, the man that creates everything, that have do everything we see around us. And he create us to have fellowship with him. In the beginning, the first man, Adam, was walk with God. Every evening he have appointment to talk with God. And they have a relationship. This was broken when Adam going against the will of God, when he don't obey God, and he eat the fruit that he was told to not eat. When he eat that fruit, this relationship with God was broken. And because this relationship was broken, the human being need to walk his own way. And we know through the story in the Bible, they went out a very wrong way. And many years later, God need to send, use Noah. That was a man of righteousness. And giving the world a new start out from Noah, because everything ran so wrong. But after that, is because God have a perfect plan from the beginning to bring us back to him. And through Jesus Christ, when Jesus comes here, the Word comes in flesh. When he comes in here, he say, he open up a new living way through the cross. He opened up the way for you and me to come in to the eternal life and with the relationship with God restored. Praise God. So when you receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and Lord, your relationship to God get restored. Your spirit inside of you get awake, get a new life. That's why we're talking about to be born again. It's not that you need to be born again. You was born as a baby, as a human being. But your spirit, the sleeping spirit inside of you, get born again. It's wake up, get new, get change to a spirit that is alive, that is in full with power and with anointing, and that can have relationship with God. A spirit that can hear the voice of God. A spirit that have connection and been renewed to the Holy Spirit every day to live in a supernatural relationship with God every day, every moment, from the morning to the evening, through all the night, and all the time in the relationship with the Father. Praise God. So the Holy Spirit is there to leading you and helping you. Jesus says to his disciples, I need to leave you and go to my Father so that I can send you the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit will be there to reveal my will, to reveal my ways, and to reveal me and the Word for you. So you understand, so you can doing the right thing. Hallelujah. So we are not lived here alone. And you know, and Paul, he write to in Ephesians that we have give the Holy Spirit as a sign, a guarantee for our eternal life. Praise God. It's so powerful. It's so powerful. And you that looking right now, if you don't live in this reality that the eternal life, it's real for you, it's time for you to join, to be a child of Jesus Christ, be a child of the Father. Right now, can you be the child of the Father? Right now, the Father is ready to adopt you, to make you as his child. Praise God. And this happened through faith. We put the faith into Jesus. We put our faith into the Word of God. We put our faith into that the Father have says it's true. Hallelujah. In this time we are many of us that maybe have grown up to without the Father. But you know, no one of us need to be without the Father. Because our Father God will be our Father. And he longing right now to be your Father too. Like he is my Father and he is Lars' Father.
Exactly.
Yes. Our fleshly Father. My Father is not living anymore. But I have a Father in heaven. Mm. I have a Father in heaven, and he will never die. He is all time there. And you know, in a few seconds, we can get all the advice we need from him. And it's so amazing, you know, when we speak and talk to him and we ask him, oh, my Father, what shall we do? What is the way? And suddenly, he only give the picture, and it's there at once, and you only say, wow. This is the right way to do.
Yes, absolutely. And you know that the communication between you and God, it's not a one-way communication, but it's a two-way communication. He communicates with us. And when I think about the beginning when Adam had and Eve had sinned, and they had been hiding from God, he was still looking for them, calling them. So even
he
when
calling there, where are you?
Where are you? Yes. So he's always calling. He's always in a personal need to have a contact and a communication and a relationship with everyone here on earth. So that's fantastic. Even if you don't think you're deserving the love of the Father, He loves you and he is searching for you. He is picking on your heart to, yes, to come in and have a meal with you. And that means that he wants to have a relationship with you, and he wants to communicate with you. He wants to lead you, guide you, just be with you, love you, hug you. And he is fantastic. And when you are going to, when you are walking with him as a friend, as a father, you are coming to know him even more from year to year. Mm-hmm. And it's easy to trust someone you know.
Yeah, that's true.
So if you don't, at the same time, if you just think, well, I believe in God. Yes, I has always believed in God. Yes, that's a start. Mm. Yes, that's a very important start. But you can't trust someone you just know with your head. But when you say, okay, God, I know, I have always believed in you. I will always believe in your existence. But now I want to have contact with you. I want to walk with you. I want to know you. Mm. And you start to talk with him. And that's the first step to have a relationship, is to start to communicate. So that's a start of step by step, also trust him more and more and more. And when you trust him, you will see very exciting things happen in your reality here. So that's fantastic. Walk by faith. that's
very good. You know, and we should have one more song of you, Lars, so when you're preparing that, you know, I will really get your attention on that, you know, right now, right here, right in this moment, you can join and be a part of this eternal life. You can be a part to be a child of the eternal Father, the creator of everything you can see around you, your creator. He have created you, and is you know, it's you're thinking, why I'm living here, why, what I doing here, you know, take it away. He have placed you where you are in the right moment, where you are in the right second in your life to receive him. And the things is not good in your life, he will change that in your life, so you can see things going right. But you need to join your life into his will. Join your life into his perfect plan for your will. That you are sitting looking this program right now is because that is his perfect will for you. It's no circumstances that you are on an accident put on this channel. No, you put on this channel because there was the perfect will of God. So, okay, Lars, let us hear.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. I would like to pray with you. If you want this relationship, if you want to be born by God in the spirit, not by flesh, not by the human will, but by God, just pray after me here. Dear Jesus, I believe that you are God. I believe that you died for my sins on the cross. I believe that you took my sin, all my sickness, all my pain, and nailed it on the cross together with you, that you died and raised up again. Forgive me my sins, and I want to walk with you. Be my Lord move into my heart. Amen. If you have prayed with me, together with me, with your own words, but you have put your faith to this prayer, and you have been born again, you are now a new creation, born by God. The old man is now gone, and the new life has begun in this moment. Amen. Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say, you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, also highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, all for love's sake became poor. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say, you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. I never know how much it costs to see my sin upon that cross. I never know how much it cost to see my sin upon that cross. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say, you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see you are all I need.
I believe you're more than enough for me. Jesus, you're all I need. 'Cause nothing is impossible for you. Nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible for you. You hold my world in your hand. I believe you're my healer. I believe you are all I need. I believe you're my portion. I believe you're more than enough for me. Jesus, you're all I need.
Amen. Yes, Jesus is really all we need. Everything starts with Jesus and ends with Jesus. He is the beginning and he is the end. And well, I just want to express my love to Jesus, because that's the ground in the whole life. So it starts with Jesus and it ends with Jesus. Amen. And about Jesus, you can open your inner eyes and you can see him before you. You can hear his voice. Open your inner ear and you can hear him. Take time with Jesus. That's my advice. That's my longing for you. I want to stare at the face of Jesus. I want to look in his eyes once more. I want to worship with all of my heart. 'Cause your love is pounding on my door. I want to stare at the face of Jesus. I want to look in his eyes once more. I want to worship with all of my heart. 'Cause your love is pounding on my door. You're all I ever need. Your presence in my life is daily keeping me. Your face is a mystery to me. Convictions in your eyes staring back at me. I know I'm loved. I know I'm wanted. I know I'm loved. I know I'm wanted. I know I'm loved. I know I want it. I want to stare at the face of Jesus. I want to look in his eyes once more. Oh, I want to worship with all of my heart. 'Cause your love is pounding on my door. Jesus, I want to look in his eyes once more.
on worship with all of my heart. Cause your love is pounding on my door. Cause your love is pounding on my door.
Tack Jesus för att du är här just nu. Thank you Jesus for being here right now. Because when we are coming together to know you, to feel you, to express you, then you are here among us. And viewers, when you have gathered in your living rooms to meet Jesus together with us, he is right there with you now. And he will restore you. He is walking there, calling your names. He wants to touch you right now with healing, with power, with joy, with changing in your lives. Hips that are not well, he wants to touch right now. The right hip is someone is washing us. Jesus will heal right now. Healing power from God is coming. I want to encourage you viewers, if you're touching the television screen right now, something fantastic will happen in your life. The healing power from God will restore you from this moment. And let us know. Send an email to us so we can thank and praise our wonderful God together. That we can join you in your gratitude for God. Yes. Lord, fill this place. Let me feel your embrace. Oh, Lord, touch this heart of mine. With your love so divine, Lord, fill this place. Let me feel your embrace. Oh Lord, touch this heart of mine with your love so divine. Let the embers burn in me. Let the fire rise to thee. You have cracked this heart of stone. Call me as your own. Lord, fill this place. Let me feel your embrace. Oh Lord, touch this heart of mine with your love so divine. Yes, Jesus. Fill every home with your presence. Fill every home with your presence, Jesus. Walk among us in every living room. Oh, touch our hearts. Touch our lives. Right now, touch our lives.
Let your Holy Spirit come over everyone watching us right now. Come, Holy Spirit, make changes from now. Lord, fill this place. Let me feel your embrace. Oh Lord, touch this heart of mine with your love so divine.
Yes, His divine love is surrounding you right now. His divine love is touching your heart right now. It's easy to do walking with God when you know that you are loved with a divine love. His divine love will change your attitude when you are going to step out and make new steps in faith. His love is going to make you relax, because you can afford to a failure, if it's what's going to happen, but that's not what's going to happen. But you can afford it because you know you are loved by God. So you don't have to be afraid. You can fall and He will rise you up again and again and again and again and again. And from this moment, your life will be filled with the presence of God. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, wonderful. It's so wonderful. You know, sometimes you say we take a song and suddenly there will be 2-3 songs. Yes. You know, when we be led by the Holy Spirit, things like that can happen. Things maybe not be exactly the way you was thinking. And I'm so blessed in this program today, Lars, and it's wonderful to see God is making things in people's life. Not only in our life, we are 3 wonderful people here in the studio right now. It's me and Lars and my wonderful wife behind the camera. And we have a good time and the praise and worship is flowing here. And yes. For a moment, it's mostly we forgot what we are here for.
Yes, it's really fantastic.
But so. We are in the living room.
Yes.
And we are in your living room together with you. We're sharing the living room and we believe the fire of God will spread out from this living room to thousands and thousands of living rooms around the world. Hallelujah. Through the satellite, we can make it. And you have turned on your satellite receiver on exactly the right channel. I don't think you need another channels you have. You only need this one. But of course, you can have another one to show your neighbors that you have many channels in your TV. But we really only need this one.
Yes, it's the only important one.
Yeah, that's true. But you know, life-changing supernatural power in your life can totally change it up and down in a moment. Sometimes it takes a little time, but God have all time in the world to help you out, whatever it is, because He loves you. You know, that is a foundation. And you know, John chapter 3, verse 16 says that God loves the world so much that He gave His begotten Son, His only Son. Hallelujah. Because He loves not how the world is looking today, but He loves you and me. He loves you and me so much that he giving his son as a gift. Maybe you is the one of them that pray together with Lars before, and you have starting your new life here. And Lars saying the end of the prayer that you are welcome to take contact with us, because we love to hear from you if you have take this stand today. But not only that we hear from you. You need to look around you in your surrounding area where you can find a local church that you can start to have relationship together with another believers. You need to have relationship with another believers to grow, and not only to grow in your faith, but to grow in your way to walk together with God, because together with another believers you take part of the experience the another believers have, and that experience is helping you on your way together with God. And God, pray to him that he leads you right now and right here to a fellowship that you are longing for. I know that in our relation fellowship here in where we are, people have sent people on many different way. Someone have only get a phone number to us and calling and ask, can I come? Another one have feeling they should go on a meeting, and suddenly they have meet someone from our church, and he says, oh, I like to follow you. So, and maybe reach a very long way to come here, but God knows and God leads, and God will lead exactly you on the right place and the right church. And sometimes he moving us from one church to another church, because it's not because it's not good the place you are, but you, God is leading you to be together with right people and the people that can help you through and walk closer and closer with him for every day, for every moment. And you know, church is not only for Sunday, the church is for the whole week. And you know, the word church, it not means a building. The word church, it means where the believers meeting one another, where the believers have fellowship with one another. Praise God. Hallelujah. So found you a good fellowship where you can praise God, where you can pray freely, where the Holy Spirit is flowing, where they are praying for the sick and the sick get healed, and people are coming in and get saved and change their life. Hallelujah. And it's good to go in a living local church where the Word of God is living and in action. Because we don't need to go to a religious place where they only have a religion tradition. Of course, still in a church like that, God can be mighty and God can help many people. So we are not against religion church. But we talk to you right now. Found a living local church that are strong in the power and anointing and flowing in the supernatural, and where they are not afraid to pray for the sick and see the sick get healed. Hallelujah. Because that will giving a strong impact in your walk with God. They will give a strong impact in your way, how your faith will grow in you, and you will go out and doing the same thing. Praise God. Hallelujah. And continue to look on the living room here on channel 316. Look on it every week. We are back every Monday evening, plus many other days when it's going in replay. But Monday evening you can see us here and follow us here in the living room. And we joining our living room with your living room. And we believe when you and me and us is gathering together in the midst of our Jesus Christ self, because he says in the word of God, when we are two or three gathering in his name, he is in the midst. So when we are gathering in our living room through the TV into your living room, we are gathering. You are maybe one sitting looking right now, or you may be a lot of people sitting looking. You know, you can start to take in your neighbors and people around and follow you every Monday evening when we have this program. And I believe that will be powerful. There will be anointing, and the fire from heaven will make a change, a fire of revival. And out from your living room, there will be a revival out to the city, out to the village. Whatever you are living is will starting a revival. It's going out and changing your whole community in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, so only join this move of revival, move of God in this time. God is using TV right now to reach out to thousands and thousands of living room on the same time, not only one by one. Because if we should travel from place to place, when I was young and was a missionary, going from village to village, going from city to city, I could only be on one place at the time. Sometimes I was in 2, maybe 3 or 4 churches on one Sunday to really try to reach so many places, so much, and going home to the homes and have Bible reading and prayer with people, pray for the sick, but I could still only be on one place at the time. And wonderful thing is that God raised up many missionaries, so we are many missionaries that is on one place at a time. But through the TV, we are going to thousands and thousands and thousands of home on the same moment, and we're doing the same thing. We pray for the sick, we share the word of God, and we are singing songs, we are worshiping Him, and we are lifting up God, and revival is coming in your home, and in your village, in your city, in your community. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Nothing is impossible for God. Hallelujah. We are not the new TV stars. We are the missionaries. It's going out with the word of God. Hallelujah. And right now, we are there. So, for you that are believers and looking this program right now, I please you to stand together with us in faith. Stand together in your prayers for us in this Channel 316, that the power of God will go out strong through this broadcasting. The power of God will penetrate and change people's life, that the power of God will be over all the different programs we putting on this channel, and the people that are doing programs to this channel, that the power of God will be over them every day. Don't forget to pray for us. That pray for us in this studio. Pray for us in the doing the different programs. And if it's some favorite programs, pray for the one that doing that program. That is so important, because your prayer will lift up the programs, will lift up the whole work to the perfect level, to the perfect will of God. Because we are dependent. We are not independent. We are dependent on Him, our Father in heaven. We are dependent on Him to follow Him, to obey Him, to walk in His perfect will. Praise God. And I believe this channel will bloom out. And I can say, among this 23 years back, I have worked in with Christian TV in Scandinavian. So are this a new step for me? I going into an area with a new experience that I don't have before. Because when we go with our Father God in heaven, we will get new experience. He leading us into new level. He leading us into new areas. Last year, God started to speak to us open up new land. Open up new land and sow the seed in righteousness. That's a very strong word from Hosea. It's a very strong word. That was given to us last year. And after that, we have only seen God. You know, in 1 month, I preach the same Bible verse every Sunday. Maybe the people get tired on me, but I preach the same. I think it was 6 times I preached the same sermon, but I think it was different every time because the Holy Spirit led a little different time. But I'm starting up in this Bible verse, open up new land. Open up the land that have been left. They have been open, but now it's no one taking care. Cultivate it again and sowing out by righteousness. Hallelujah. And something will start to happen. And we sow after that, and we put our belief in this word. Something start to happen around us. Suddenly things being open up that we have praying for many years that should be happen, and maybe working for should be happen, but not been happen. But suddenly God only open the doors like that. And we were only, wow. And we are amazed what God is doing. Because we put our faith in to this word he gave to us. And when we put our faith in to this Bible verse he giving to us, things start to happen. And it's so amazing the way he is working. So you need to put your faith into the word he giving to you. The word he giving to you. That is the key that will open the doors that you are knocking on and is never open. You need his word into that situation. And he will totally change it and making a new way. Amen. And I think we will end with this word today and this broadcasting. And you know, we are coming back next week. And you know, I tell you, pray for us. Pray for this station. Pray for the broadcasting. It's going out through channel 316. Pray for all them you see on the screen. And behind the screen, you know, it's a lot of people that are doing different things. Pray for all of us that we are preaching the right thing, we are telling the right thing and doing the right thing, and the power of God will be over the different programs. And I will say thank you to you, Lars, that have been together with us today. And it's so wonderful to be together with you.
Yes, thank you. Thank you. I'm very happy to be here.
Yes.
And it's fantastic to be together. And
yeah. So let us only end here and pray together with you. It's looking the program right now. And you can be together with us in this prayer. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Right now we are lifting up all our viewers to you. You know who is looking right now. And you know what problem they has or what sickness they have. And I only pray right now, let your healing power go out to everyone that is it's in belief right now. Believe you for a touch in Jesus' name. Touch the heart. Touch the sickness to go right now. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
And lift up, you know, and stir it up the spiritual life. Some of you have lived very strong in the Holy Spirit, but right now the God says you need to stir it up your Holy Spirit in your life again. We only release that. Mm. We release that right now. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
The name of Jesus.
The name of Jesus.
Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus, for your power, your anointing. It's coming over the TV viewers right now. in the name of Jesus Christ. And thank you for the beginning work here with Channel 316, that we only can put it in your hand. We're putting the programming in your hands. We're putting the finances in your hand. We're putting this mission completely in your hands, to be the one it's leading it and helping us, and you are the one is showing us the next step, and you are bringing in the right people to doing programs here, and you're bringing in the finances, you're bringing in whatever it needed to make this channel strong and powerful. And we pray for all the technique to work well, and if it's something we are lacking there, we are praying that shall come in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
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 Hallelujah. It's wonderful to pray together. Some of this all time little different way, but this way was God leading us right now. And thank you for that you follow us today. We are back next week, same time, same channel. And I really believe that you are blessed today, and you will be blessed forward. So only follow all the programs on Channel 316. God bless you, mighty.
Welcome to Channel 316, and we'd love to know where you're from. Those from Africa, you can email us on 316.tv and visit our page also on Facebook. Yeah. Go in and like us and write to us.
My name is Andrea Josefsson. I'm living here in Sweden in this mission here, 316 Victory Center Church. And welcome in this channel. This is very new channel, and we would like you to stand with us and pray for us in this mission. So we would like to ask you to send a prayer request so we can pray for you. And all Filipinos that are looking right now all over the world, so you are welcome to stand with us. And we would like that you open your internet, and you can see in the through internet, so you do need to open your TV if you have no TV in your living room, so even the internet you can see us. And we ask you to be with us in this mission.
In my heart. say.